Welcome back to our channel startuplanes.com. I am Murit Tanvi, and as you know that these are the series of interviews that we are conducting for the startup of the month. For today's interview we have Ms. Khushbu Pal. She is the founder of Ayurmart. Mr. Surendra Kumar Saho is also founder and CEO. He is giving 5 years of experience in startup, and Mr. Rajendra Kumar Saho, founder and director of Ayurmart. They came up with this idea during pandemic as the fruits and vegetable becomes necessity and it was difficult to get farm fresh vegetables. So they started connecting with farmers and formed Ayurmart, an online grocery platform. Recently they have launched their mobile application on Play Store also, and also Ayurmart is the part of the group Ayuru. So let's jump into the interview directly.
So good afternoon, ma'am. I am More Tanvi from Startup Lanes, and we are grateful to have you on the board for this interview. Yes. I would request you to introduce yourself to our viewers, please.
Hello. So my name is Khushbu Pal. I am the founder of Ayurmart, having 4 years of experience in software development. And my partners are Mr. Surendra Kumar Sahu. He is founder and CEO, having 5 years of experience in startup. And Rajendra Kumar Sahu, he's having 4 year around of experience in marketing. So we three started this startup, and recently we have launched our mobile application on Play Store. And previously we were working on web-based application. So successfully we are having around 1 lakh of customers onboarded on our platform, and with 500 of vendors.
Okay, great. So my very first question to you is that how did you come up with this idea of your startup?
Yeah. So like as in last lockdown during that pandemic, everyone is in need of the basic necessity of life, like vegetables, grocery and foods. And it was hard to get the fresh vegetables as to make our immunity system strong and healthy. So during that complete lockdown, market were closed. Many farmers were dependent on their daily wages, like selling the vegetable in the vegetable market. But that source of it was also stopped. Mm-hmm. So the only option they had to sell the vegetables door to door, but due to restrictions, they were not allowed to do that. So we three decided, and we come up with this idea, ki why not to join the farmers, or why not to create a platform where the farmers can come up and then can list their products, or our team will help them to list the products, and they can sell directly to the customers. No middleware, no middlemen, directly they can sell to the customers. So that is how Ayurmart generated, and we started working on that.
Okay. So I would like to know that what are the difficulties you faced at the early stage of your journey?
Yeah. So the most difficult part in the early stage of company, three things we have faced. Like first one is to set up the resources. Mm-hmm. Second, for marketing, like how to approach the most of the customers. And the third one is team buildup. These three we are facing. And we started this with the bootstrap funding, with the help of our family, friends, and with a positive approach, we just started it.
Okay. So like, I would like to know, what is the gap that you identified in the market?
Okay. So the major gap was between the farmers and customers. Like in many of the, or major of the platforms, they are having warehouses where they used to stock the things, the vegetables and fruits. And most of the time, and even in the pandemic, customers were not getting the fresh things. So this gap we identified, and like Ayurmart is not having any warehouse. It is just a platform. Here we are directly connecting them, farmers, with the customers. So this, we can say, a kind of bridge between them. Here farmers can sell their products and use our delivery service also. We provided them. And we not only created a platform, but we are also supporting them to serve a large number of area, not only their surroundings, but other places also.
Okay. So ma'am, can you explain your business model in detail?
Okay. So our business model is based on two parts. Like first one is the transaction charges. Means the customer, on every booking, we are charging them. And the other is for the vendors, like grocery we also introduced. So from the small scale or the vendors, we are charging as a subscription charge. And for the farmers, we still kept it as a free. They can use that service. So these are the two building blocks, or these are the two major business models we are having.
Okay. Ma'am, as you mentioned before that your friends and family help you funding your startup. So I would like to know that like ever you have approached the investors?
We have approached and still also we are approaching, but yet not any investor converted. So okay. Still we are looking for the funding.
So ma'am, how you are approaching investors in this situation?
Yeah, like going through various events and attending the events and approaching them directly on the LinkedIn also.
Mm-hmm.
So mailing them our pitch deck and explaining them about our idea. So we are hoping that still we'll get some good response from the investors.
Okay. Ma'am, as you said that you started your company in the pandemic. So what are the other factors that you see impacting your business in the coming years?
In the coming years, that may affect like in major of the platforms which are right now in the market, they are going out of stocks, many things they are having. So with the groceries, it may be. So in coming years and future, it may require that we also go opt that option for the warehouse.
Mm-hmm.
But right now we are planning to make it asset free or like just a direct connection.
Okay. So ma'am, as you said that it's a fresh company. So I would like to know that are you planning to hire fresh talents in your company?
Yeah, definitely. We are planning to, and even virtual events also we are planning for the freshers. Like in many colleges also we are going to organize that. So yeah, fresh candidates we are planning to hire.
Yes. So what are the personality traits or what are the basic traits you are looking in the fresh talents?
Okay. So a fresher candidate should have the creative thinking or convincing power and a positive approach also. Like in a startup, at every stage, you have to face a new challenge.
Hmm.
So a candidate must have that positive approach that how to tackle that and how to come up with a creative idea to solve that, not to give up. And it should be energetic. So these are the characteristics or these are the skills we are looking for.
Okay. Ma'am, you're the founder of your company. So I would like to know that according to you, what are the personality traits of a good leader?
Okay. So according to me, a good leader should be motivated and should be a good initiator.
Mm-hmm.
Like if they are having a creative idea, they are having a good approach, but they should be initiator and then that should be convincing to explain their team, to make them or to categorize it like step by step, what we have to do first, what we have to do next and what methodology we have to use. So mm-hmm. like this, you should be understandable to others. So that I think that is the main thing required in a leader.
Okay. So what is the good part and what is the bad part of being a CEO?
Okay. So I would like to go with the worst part first.
Yeah.
So being in CEO, the first thing is no personal life.
Hmm.
In CEO, your first priority is your company.
True.
So many times it happens that we have to miss our family gatherings because we have to give more time to our company and more time to our idea also, like how to go to the next step, what to do, like track session, all the things in planning. So that is the worst part.
Okay.
Yeah. The best part being in CEO, it teaches you a lot of things.
Mm-hmm.
Like sometimes it seems that all the things are against me. And in that negativity, we lost our motivation. So in that fight with you, somewhere it makes us mentally strong, which is very required in a entrepreneur's life.
Mm-hmm.
So that is the best part.
Okay. Ma'am, describe a time you had making a tough decision, for example, budget cuts or organizational restructuring or market withdrawals, etc.
The tough time was like in last year. It was a situation we have to close the offices and all because due to a fund issue, that situation arises. Like we are not able to pay the employees also. So at that time was tough, but with the friend helps, with the family helps, we resolve that issue. We come up with that and we continue our idea. We not give up on the idea, but we change our methodology. We change our way to work on that.
Okay. So ma'am, what did you do for it and what are the results now?
IAS application. So that is under testing phase. Soon we are going to launch it also.
Okay. Ma'am, can you repeat? Actually, I was just speaking, so I didn't hear it properly.
Okay. So currently we are working on our IAS application. So that is under testing phase. Soon we are going to launch that also.
Okay. Ma'am, are you looking for any vendor to help you simplify any part of your business?
Yeah, we are looking for. mainly in the funding.
Okay, so investors mainly.
Yes.
Yeah. So, ma'am, lastly, I would like to know that what are your recent and long-term plans of your startup?
Okay. So, recent plan is to launch our iOS application and acquire those customers also, reach them to the iOS users also. And in long-term plan, we are planning to expand RU Mart all over the India and connect as many farmers as we can.
Okay. Ma'am, lastly, I would request you to say something to your viewers or our viewers.
Okay. So the one thing which I learned from my father, he whenever I get demotivated, he used to say me like that, ki, never sit idle. Just keep learning. If it seems that ki, nothing is happening, all things are against you, but keep learning. At least learn. Because whatever you learn, that never get wasted.
Mm-hmm.
So invest your time in learning. It will keep you motivated. Read books as many as you can.
Okay. Ma'am, surely this advice will help all, like not only the entrepreneurs, but also other peoples out there. And thank you so much. And we are thankful for having you on this board for this interview.
Thank you. Thank you, Tanvi, for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.
Yes.